While I definitely understand the challenges that OCA has with dealing with the local government, particularly New York City, and DCAS controls the properties, access to justice, as you know, begins with the doorway that you walk through. In Staten Island, we finally, after several years, were able to open up a brand new courthouse, and as you know, 5 minutes after the door opened, we had outgrown that courthouse. Part of the plan for the replacement of the Staten Island courts was to consolidate the family court into the Supreme Court at 18 Richmond Terrace, and the criminal court, which was at Targhee Street. There was a desire on the part of most of the elected officials to keep that building open and operational. Unfortunately, that building is closed, and moving everything now to the new courthouse, creating some backlogs there. But now we're even told that the plan that was to move our family court, which is, we are the only borough that has not gotten a new family court out of all of the courts, out of all five boroughs, but that dilapidated building, which essentially consists of two courthouses, you know the conditions that, you know, litigants and families and attorneys, it's just awful. That plan to move them to 18 Richmond Terrace is now not going to happen. So we have a real concern, and while, again, you don't build the buildings, you know, and you don't control the properties, it would be very helpful to us if OCA would make the case that you're not able to administer justice appropriately to the citizens of Richmond County because of the City of New York's failure to recognize that the property that they own, they are not maintaining correctly, and they're not planning for it. To allow a sitting courthouse to just close the doors and rot, in my opinion, is negligent to the people of the City of New York, and we need you and OCA to step up and say that that is just the wrong way to go about it. So we're hoping that you will join us in our demand that the city revisit this decision to close Targhee Street and shut off what should be a viable courthouse for the delivery of justice to the people of Richmond County. So I'm hoping I can count on you for that.
You can count on us. I mean, you could make the argument that the family court situation in Staten Island could be the number one facilities priority that we have in the court system in the city today. Mm-hmm. So, there's an architect that the city's retained. We're expecting to see some proposals coming from this architect very shortly, and the community will absolutely be involved in the decision-making process. And I promise you that I'll work closely with you, and we'll be a strong advocate for coming up with a plan that makes the most sense for Staten Island.
Mm-hmm. And I'm not going to belabor too much the raise the age issue because we are going to have a hearing on it next week, so it will be totally examined by the Senate. But one of the questions that comes up from time to time is if we transfer these cases to family court, that family court judges are not equipped to handle cases around that. And I try and remind people that family court judges now deal with young people who are juvenile delinquents, who would be prosecuted for some of these things if they were just over the age of 16. Can you talk about some of the types of cases that family court judges do deal with juvenile delinquent cases?
Well, family court deals with the whole range of crime, from the least significant misdemeanor to, in some instances, the most serious violent felony. And there's concurrent jurisdiction with the criminal courts, the adult courts, with the most serious, homicide and the most serious felony cases. But they handle some of those cases themselves. Family court judges are equipped to handle the whole gamut of crimes and range of criminal offenses that we have in our penal laws in New York.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for that. And finally, in 2015 and in 2016, the Senate and the Assembly passed unanimously a piece of legislation that would extend three-quarter disability benefits to court officers if they were injured on the job in defense of a judge or lawyers in the courtroom. Currently, as you know, if they are injured on the job, if a chandelier falls on their head, right, they're entitled to a three-quarter disability benefit. But they weren't if they were defending, a judge or an attorney or a litigant in the court. So we felt we should extend that benefit to them, passed it unanimously in both houses 2 years in a row. The governor vetoed it twice. And his His reasoning was that being injured on the job in protection of a judge or an attorney or a litigant is an inherent risk of their job, and therefore they shouldn't be extended this protection. Obviously, the legislature disagrees. We're prepared to take it up again. And I'm just curious, do you think, as the chief judge, administrative judge, that this is something that we should correct for these officers? The same way we do for corrections officers or police officers or anyone else. And I understand the position you're in, but what do you think?
Personally, I could see the argument for that. Institutionally, we have not opposed that. We've formally, in a letter to the governor's council, we've taken no objection to the signing of the bill. So, as I said, personally, you could probably convince me there's great merit to that proposal. Institutionally, we've taken no position. We've expressed no objection, which is actually a little bit stronger than taking no position. In the end, I don't know, if we had affirmatively supported it, would that have made a difference? I don't know. That's something we could think about, though.
I think there was a concern that it might be a very costly benefit, but the truth is it happens so rarely. It might be two or three cases in a 10-year period of time. It just seems like it's the right and just thing to do. And, this legislature rarely acts unanimously. To have done so 2 years in a row sends a signal. So we would appreciate, your support on this effort as we move it again. So thank you, Judge Marks.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Senator.